Today on the workshop, something we don't do nearly enough of, import fast cars. 1995 Toyota Supra, 95 being the year I graduated. You saw me show off the 95 Eclipse by Mitsubishi from AMT in 1/25th scale a little bit ago as an unboxing. This one I'm going to be doing a full build on because I am a Toyota fan. It's got the twin turbo VVTi engine, removable top, big spoiler, roll bar, optional racing seats. It's got a lot of cool stuff in the box, so let's get a look to it. Now, it is molded in this chartreuse green, which actually has, it doesn't, I thought it had a metallic shade to it, but that's just the way the light was hitting it. It's very attractive. It's a very, very vivid green in person. The body is nicely molded. You can't build a completely stock car from this kit, just know that right away. I want to see how that pull-off top actually fits on there, deciding whether I'll use it or not. We got our interior tub here, nice textured carpet detail. We got some thumps back there. Those are subwoofers for a little bit of action as you go down the street with that hatch trunk on there. That's nice looking, easy enough to detail that interior. We've got underhood detail, shock towers and whatnot, even with the ubiquitous three bolts on them. Reservoir tank on there. Underneath, typical stamped frame from Toyota. Got the rails, got all the stamped all together with the fuel tank back there. Nice detail on it. The green plastic helps show that off a lot easier than white plastic. Green, this will be easy to paint over. No, it's green, I can't paint over it. You're wrong. You'll be able to paint over it just fine. Beautiful hood. I love the intakes on the hood. We'll be able to get that all painted, a little bit of black wash in there. We'll bring those right out, or you could paint them another color. We got our transaxle, suspension, both ends, tie rod there, snaps on. We've got enormous wheel backs, looks like an oil pan or bottom of a transmission. Interior and exterior details, we've got mirrors. We've got some sort of little grill here. I'm not sure what all of these are. Obviously, these are the spindles. Looks like we'll have steerable, posable steering if you wish. Rear view mirror in the body color. E-brake, I'm just calling them out as I spot them and recognize them. Massive wheel backs on that thing. We got struts with their springs. We've got, looks like a spoiler, part of the roll cage, links on there, suspension links. Nice looking work on those struts, by the way. Those will be fun to paint up and detail. We got our exhaust system. We got on this one here, we've got our front cover plate and that roof. Nicely molded. Can't wait to see. That goes on like so. It's got trim built into that on either side. On the seats here, these are the stock-ish seats, but they've got a racing harness in them. Our seat backs. Two parts. You could do a two-tone seat if you desired very easily. Exhaust system. Huge exhaust. That big, thick, all the emissions control. We got what looks like spoiler parts, suspension, I think. Steering. Nice tree there. Be very careful. Don't break off your turn signal indicators and your tilt wheel. And see all the accoutrement. Looks like an air intake there. Sway bar. More of the roll bar. A lot of parts in this kit. Very surprised for its age and the subject matter. Nice front clips. You could always do a banged up version where half this clip is duct taped on. That's very common. Or primered. Doesn't match the body. That's very common in my area. There's our racing seats, which would look nice in numerous different vehicles. Door panels, speakers, holes for the armrests and other details on there. Nicely done. We've got that beautiful 90s Toyota cockpit wraparound dashboard. All kinds of detail inside there with carbon fiber texture on the face. We got the serpentine system, fans, engine. We got nice slotted disc brakes all the way around. I have no idea what that is, but we'll find out. We've got the engine and transmission as halves. We got our nice battery in there with actual battery wires coming down the sides. Intercooler or radiator, not sure which one it is on this one. Windshield wipers are separate. Nicely done. Let's switch to the other side of the desk. We've got our clear parts, the big hatch, the side, the headlights, front glass, fog lamps, turn signals, and clear red tails. Four low profile, high performance directional tires. A little sanding will really make those look nice. They are directional, so make sure you put them on the right way or driving in the rain is going to be a pain. Nice wheels, only one wheel option in this one. The Eclipse had two. If you like that, grab the Eclipse and you'll have all kinds of wheel options for all these import builds. We got numerous dress-up parts for the twin turbo. Like those wheels, some black washing. It's going to look sweet in there. And the new decal sheet. Big Packer fan there. If you are a big Packer fan, you got your all set there. You can make a Packer Supra. We got some shark stripes there. They definitely look like a shark. We got tail, fin. We got some tribal markings. I really do like these. They definitely say 90s. We got nice white cobra stripe or center stripe all the way down. We got NOS decals. We got AMT. We got turn signals. I'm really digging these tribal ones. They even go around the door handle. We got optional hood decals for those. We got, six license plates? All having something funny to say. We got dash gauges. We got NOS bottle emblems. Nice decal set there. Well done by AMT. I'm going to start building up my version. I'll be right back. A quick look at the sub-assemblies. All of this took me about 90 minutes to get to. These AMT kits usually go together pretty smooth, especially the more modern ones. We got our e-brake and our shifter. I don't need that any of that to be chrome. And I want to do this all in the monotone gray Toyota interiors. And then we'll dress up the speaker box. We've got our amplifiers that go back here. We've got our nitrous bottles that also mount in there. So we've got some details to add that I'll be painting separately. This giant tree here, I want to prime everything on this tree in one color. Then I will cut parts free and spray them their final colors before detailing. So I've left the dashboard on there, the lights. I did attach the shroud to the radiator. We've got the spoiler assembled. Then that will be cut free and painted its final color. Same with the brake rotors and calipers will have to be hand painted. I'll enjoy that. Our hoses, fan, belt and pulley system will all get painted and glued together, and our amplifiers will get painted and then detailed separately along with our really nice looking battery. If you didn't see that in the parts review, that battery is really, really nice, and so is the dashboard on there. The engine block, transmission, timing cover, all of that are attached with the starter. We'll be painting that up based on pictures I saw on the interwebs. Remember, this is a fully customized car, so any color you choose to paint anything is yours and yours alone. Build and paint for you. I'm never going to stop saying it. We got our wheel backs. We got the brace on the underbody around the exhaust master cylinder, mirror, license plate frame, and those big wheel backs that pretty much hide everything behind them. Those are all set to go and get primed up and painted. Our mirrors are cut free. I cut the tops of the tree off, left the bottom on. That'll be the easiest to touch up without seeing it. Because on the body, I love that they have pre-mounted locating holes. The body parts, front and rear, push on with large locating pins on both sides. Use good old model glue. I like Bondine for myself, but you use whatever you like. Any liquid glue is great these days. Those hold on. And the chassis, I did the front suspension because I wanted to glue the front steering in place. It is completely steerable if you leave the spindles and the tie rod unglued. They just push in. You can move those. I glued mine on tight to hold tight, but otherwise that is all one nice piece. The exhaust, the rear suspension and driveline will be mounted in later, so you can see all those go together. The firewall can go in now and get painted up with the rest of it. That's going to be pretty sharp looking. I've got some ideas. I like these when I can completely customize a vehicle to what I would like to drive. The steering column and steering wheel locked together nicely. I've got those glued. We've got our radiator line right there. We'll get that primed and painted. The roll cage, I assembled it on the interior to make sure everything lined up. Then I detached it after the glue had set for a few seconds. We can get that painted up on its own with its own accent color. The hood is a separate piece. We'll paint that up. The removable top looks like it goes on real nice and easy, so I'll leave that separate, paint it. The interior door panels just need their armrests attached, and we can get those painted up. They've got nice large pins. Do not cut those off. Those will push into the interior so that you know you have them in the correct locations. We've got our underbody pan. They say you can do it in body color, but if you want to do a little accent underneath the car, paint it whatever color you want. Rear struts are only off the car so that I can get them painted because I have to do the driveline separately. I want to paint and detail the driveline in the back, then attach it to the car, so we'll have those as separate pieces. I'm going to go with the one-piece racing seats. Anyone who's going to spend this much money on their car is going to throw in some cool seats so it shows off when the ladies hop in and go for a ride. We got our wheels. You can see they're cut free of the chrome tree. I want to hit these with a matte coat and some black washing to make them look like real aluminum instead of chrome. And then finally, our exhaust, our cold air intake, and our intake filter are all on one tree. We're going to get those painted up a metallic, and then I'll hand detail that air filter on there. So that is all the parts. Oh, almost forgot the nitrous bottles. I super glued them together. I don't want them to be chrome. I want them to be blue, like the old nitrous bottles with their logos. So those I'm going to be painting up, priming and painting. That's all the parts. I'm going to get into the paint booth now, and you can come along with. before I wrap everything up, let me show you where I is on the build. We've got that beautiful engine installed with its blue engine cover. Got our turbos with the black washes on them. I want them to look like they've been through a lot of heat treatments and they weren't still shiny chrome. We got our little battery mounted in there. I did the front of the radiator slash intercooler in aluminum color because we're going to be able to see it through that big old snorkel in the front of the car. So I wanted to highlight that so we can see that in there. We got the strut tower brace glued in across the two. I just have to attach the air cleaners and the intakes and the lines and stuff once it's all buttoned up inside and I can get to it without worrying about breaking them off. So that is all set under the hood underneath. We've got our awesome exhaust system. I haven't attached the big fart pipe yet. Fuel tank. You can see I black washed that rear drive line and suspension. Made all the different areas stand out. So that is pretty awesome looking underneath there. And our wheel and tire package will go on underneath. So that looks outstanding. The wheel and tire package, when you spend a little bit of time on it, is pretty electric looking. It is awesome sauce. With the rotors back there, the brakes, it's got the black walls on the back so that it doesn't shine through. Those look sweet. Make sure you build them directionally because of those chevron-shaped tires. And then you can turn them on the axles. Most of the time, the rotor will be towards the back of the car if the instruction manual doesn't tell you. The interior is another nice-looking, more modern. Now, I left these holes out. The other NOS tank is empty. He's got it in for a refill. So he's remounting it, so I left that one out. I just didn't paint up the other one. I like just the one in there. We got our amps in the back. We got our subwoofers painted up inside. We've got our roll cage in. We've got our carbon fiber optional seats in there with their bright yellow belts. I blacked out the speaker grills on the doors. And that excellent looking dashboard with big honking tack with a little yellow Tamiya clear for the shift light. Gauges are all in there. And it all looks great. It all looks the part of a Yoda from the 90s. It's a nice looking interior. And then we get to the body. Now, I've got just stuff loosely on there so you can see it all by itself. The roof still comes off. The cool looking hood with its vents comes off. And that faux carbon fiber wing will remove so you can see how it's going to look. We've got our windshield wipers on there. They're individual pieces. They look outstanding. The glass all lines up. The side lights. Now, a lot of these will have black all the way around. It's a custom painted car, so I just did the insulation around each glass and left the green on the sidebars and all that. That's how I want mine to look. Got our taillights in there. You could accentuate each taillight. I painted the area black or silver behind them, then pushed them in. I also painted them black from behind, so they looked a little smoked out. You can see the red tint to them, but they look more smoked out. That's the custom look I want on there. And then the headlights and everything installed on the front end. So very easy build so far. Everything's pushing together the way it should. I haven't had to fiddle or fight with anything. We'll see how the interior actually squeezes in to the chassis. And it fits in tight enough that you can turn it upside down on its own. And that's how it's going to look. So we'll be gluing that in tightly and then pushing it in. We're going to decide what of these decals I want to use. And when I come back, we'll have the final. Another stress-free two-day build. All the stuff I've been getting from round two. I've been really lucky this year where it's all been nice, fun, easy builds. And this one definitely is easy. You could easily tackle this as a first glue kit. You get the kids this, the grandson, the granddaughter, the son, the daughter, or yourself. You want to build up, say, hey, 95, you know, this is when grandpa was just getting done with high school. It was when I had my first job, got done with college. Can you believe that's 25 years ago? This thing is a classic plus 5 years already. It's unbelievable. The decals went on beautifully. I used the ghosting transparent decals, the gray. They'll show up better in the pictures on the rotation video. When the light hits them just right, you can see those beautiful tribal markings exactly as I would want to do mine, but they will show up better in pictures. They're just there, which I don't like to overstate them. The wheel and tire package, I think, is the standout. Then the interior, how nice that dashboard looks with the amps and the NOS tank and the subs in there. That twin turbo engine is absolutely beautiful under the hood. I like how my oil rubbed bronze that I like using for carbon fiber turns out real slick. Lots of detail, but the kit pushes together. I use the optional seats and painted them carbon fiber with the belts. You could go with the stockish seats with the belts. You could rebuild it up as the Fast and Furious car. You could do whatever you want with it, and you're going to have a good time. Now, I left the top removable, but I did complete the top. So we can open it up, see inside, and the pictures will be able to see inside much better then. But I do like it with the top off. I won't be really doing much with that top myself. I like it like this. That's how I would drive one around if I did build a tuner like that. And it looks really sweet. They include that little tachometer there with the shift light. We got the speakers in the doors. It's a really tight ride, man, and I enjoyed the build. Now, this won't be the only import I do. I try to do as many as I can. There's just not a massive amount of them on the market, but Round 2 has also sent their Nissan 350Z, and I plan on building that one up too. We can see how nice the taillights fit in, the license plate mount, that huge fart pipe on the back, or performance exhaust. Everything looks sweet, and I really like when I do the carbon fiber mirrors that he picked up off of eBay. They just set the car off a little different, give it a little bit of a detail, black out those hood vents on there so we can cool off. And when it went around, you could see how easy it is to see that radiator slash intercooler, the front end all in aluminum. It looks nice behind that little grill. So enjoyable build. I've got 2 days in this, like most of my car builds, and I didn't struggle or fight with anything. Had a lovely time. I will link in the description where you can get yours. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. Build your models for you. Don't forget, when this kit is done, you're gonna have a buttload of decals left over. License plates, AMT logos, NOS logos. You're going to have all kinds of stuff. So have fun. Order your kits. Show me your builds on Facebook. As always, HPI Guys Workshop on Facebook. I like seeing your guys' stuff. And we will see you at the next review.